Welcome back to Weekend Art. My name is Gaurav. Naam to suna hoga. देखिए आर्टिस्ट होना और अच्छा आर्ट बनाना ये तो बहुत ही क्रिएटिव चीजें हैं. बट समथिंग दैट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज वंस आपने अच्छा आर्ट पीस बना दिया है हाउ वुड यू टेक इट टू पब्लिक. यू नीड अ प्लेटफॉर्म एंड आर्ट फेयर was one such platform that gave a chance to a lot of upcoming and already established artists. And these artists were not only from the UAE, but artists who came from around the world to display their pieces of art. Art, as they say, is the most intense mode of individualism that the world has known. A work of art in any space makes a stronger statement than 1,000 words put together. The Dubai Art Fair was an inspiring 3-day event that displayed more than 30 original works from international galleries and independent artists from across the world who displayed their original paintings, prints, sculptures and photography all under one roof.
I think we have around more than 100 artists participating with us, and I think the interesting part is that they're coming all on from all over the world, from Austria, Mexico, Italy. I think this is an international affordable art fair. I think we realize there is a niche, Pooja and me, that we don't get such kind of art where people can relate to and which is not very expensive, and I not think about too much when I'm buying it. So I think this art fair is going to bridge the gap between the local buying art community and all the international galleries from across the world.
The fair acted as a bridge between artists, art galleries and the local art buying community in Dubai and ran under the slogan, Aspire Art, Access Art, Acquire Art. Visitors got the opportunity to interact with the artists themselves and acquire knowledge about them and their work.
Well, all of this entire body of work is quite new. It's experimental. My work is naturally a lot more figurative, but after moving to the UAE, I've tried to adapt it a bit.
I guess the inspiration behind it, it's my spiritual journey, Buddhism, angels, and the whole process of going within yourself to find yourself, connect with your higher self, and it's that kind of journey of life.
The diverse cultural scene in Dubai made this fair more interesting for art lovers as well as first-time buyers, since they got the chance to buy original works from local and international artists.
This is a great art fair which brings together well-established senior artists as well as upcoming young artists from many countries, and it gives them great exposure.
It just gave me such a variety of artists, of course, and from a variety of countries. But I came here thinking it was going to be just Indian artists, but there's so many others. But I was fascinated by, you know, work from Central Asia, from India, Pakistan, and it's just marvelous, very beautiful.
It brought together an eclectic mix of emerging as well as established talents to showcase their work. This presented a unique marketing opportunity in the multicultural and contemporary city of Dubai. It brought this incredible city the most exciting work of imagination and creativity. Now, art in any form requires certain skills, right? Some craftsmanship, some risk-taking abilities even. Like for example, I think that running a successful business in a highly competitive market like the UAE or the Middle East in itself is an art. And who honors these artists? Well, that's exactly what the Forbes magazine did. At an event held recently, they honored the top 100 executive managers in the region.
Global corporations play a vital role in global economic growth and success. But behind the formidable corporate facades is an impressive talent pool. Keeping this in mind, Forbes Middle East proudly presented a pioneering ranking under the theme Global Meets Local. Under this theme, Forbes Middle East recognized the achievements of the top 100 leading global corporate powerhouses in the MENA region at an exclusive event held in Dubai.
The criteria basically, like, you know, what we look at is how strong the company is globally, and like, you know, their financial influence, their geographic study, and it also depends on, like, you know, how the business has been a leader for how many years. So it's not like, you know, he's just joined as a CEO with a company for a year or something. We don't do that. So, or like, you know, we don't take the budding entrepreneurs or like budding CEOs like who's been there for 2-3 years. So over the years, like, you know, if you've noticed, like, you know, the introduction, what you've noticed, everybody would have started their career in 90s. And in 2014, they've been selected as the top CEO of Forbes.
When it comes to business leaders, the company is only as good as the visionary at the helm, because everything and everyone else is a reflection of the business proficiency and contextual wisdom of the person who calls the shots.
Whenever we have an event and a ranking, we always love having the events and seeing people's faces when they get the awards. It's always great to recognize business people in the region and their success and their achievements. I don't think people get awarded enough for their achievements, so it's great to give people a pat on the back for what they've done.
It's always good to be recognized. So definitely recognitions come because of teamwork. And I'm very thankful for my team for enabling me to get this award.
It's definitely a great privilege and honor, you know, to be awarded, you know, such prestigious award, you know, this evening. And I think it's just culmination, you know, of all the efforts, you know, not just for myself, but, you know, from all the stakeholders, you know, and the partners that have been involved, you know, in building the brand of McDonald's in the region, you know, for the past 20 years.
Global companies are increasingly looking eastward in pursuit of corporate success. Economic growth for the GCC is expected to rise to 4.1% in 2014, compared to an anticipated global growth of only 3.6%. This is not just a percentage. Behind this growth are a host of efficient business leaders that are driving not only their organizations, but economies at the national, regional, and global levels towards prosperity.
So we've shown you everything there was to show in this first episode of the new year, except the most important thing, and that is food. So you and I are going to have a great meal, but before that, we need to take a short little break.